Hello, I'd like to welcome back to Turok, the Dinosaur Hunter. But today we're gonna go to Treetop Village. Those look like trees, I guess. This level has only two secrets, if I remember correctly. One is not that far into this kind of into the level, the other is also somewhere in the level. I think the other one is the end. It also is the, yeah. There are, I think I might play a couple of custom levels, actually, and try out a couple of mods that look pretty cool, like Turok Plus fixes a whole bunch of crap. Like, did you know? God, I was waiting to say that. Did you know? These guys drop health depending on how many times you shoot them. Nothing to do with damage, which is really annoying. Oh no! You ate a shit! That's not what I want to do. Well, now I know everything about all my achievements. Ah, oh, that's so sad. Why would I press tab? Oh no, I unlock cheats, infinite lives. I should just do that at the beginning of every fucking episode. Catching my nose, this one has guns. That's not good. No, it ain't! Sonny boy, old pal, old chummy old friend. This part's annoying. You'll know why soon enough. Essentially, if you fall too far at anywhere, but the designated platforms, the game instantaneously counts it as a loss. Oh. They stole the Star Tumble off the Star Wars. Oh, that's a tight jump. Probably not how you're supposed to do that then. Yeah, I'm kinda excited to try Turok Plus. Cause it looks like it really fixes up a couple of things. What is the dude over there? Now he's dead. Oh, this is how you're supposed to get up here, huh? What is a grenade? I might as well pick that up. Yeah, I remember that this level isn't all that great. It's very samey, is one of the big things this level does. This requires you to look down a bunch. Now who the fuck looks down? What kind of crazy Machiavellian scheme requires a man to look down? I say it's a Machiavellian man. Machiavellian scheme. Tech armor. Super grenade. Drop shot. Man, I do love that announcer, man. He knows how to bring some zest to the party. Like that! Nice and zesty. Oh no! You ate shit and died! Aren't you just a sad sack of shit? This grenade arcs more than you think. But less than you wanted to! God damn it! Now I feel obliged to do a... Man, I really do miss that fucking thing Chugga Conroy did with Splatoon. It was really... I think I just want to watch him all that. That's the first time I ever fucking gonna do that, but I really do did like it. And it's so much zest to it. And I love zest. And I miss it. On one end, I kinda understand why you had to stop. And those Splatoon 2 is coming. And perhaps someone else who I like that commentates can do it. Cause that's the one thing that kinda bothers me. There is someone who actually in my subscription list does play Splatoon, but they don't commentate, and I feel that something of the game's zest and energy is lost. Without something anxiously screaming about how great they're doing. It's such a childish game. What does churlish mean? The word churlish suddenly comes to mind. Why? Church. Sounds like Winston Churchill. Related? Mayhaps? I forgot, we haven't done this one today. Yep. Okay. Let's go and have ourselves an ancient Chinese secret, I guess. What are yours on these motherfuckers? I guess I could use my tech ball a bit. I guess I could use my tech ball a little bit. Let's shoot that guy over there. Cause he's an asshole. Although it kinda depends on where you live. You might be an asshole. Remember to always check with your local culture and customs to make sure that you are pronouncing things the correct way. When going down south, always say, hi. adapt to local customs. When in Rome, do as the Romans do. By which I mean, don't order a fucking pig sandwich while you're in Arabia. That's a shitty idea. Not to mention disrespectful of people and their cultures and customs. But for the same fucking note, if you're an asshat coming to our town, you better be ready to adapt our culture.
Motherfucker.
You'll get respect where respect is due, but don't expect me to pull a magic bullet out of my fucking ass and suddenly think that you're the best. Cultural appropriation goes both ways, unfortunately, and people make a big mess, and then they cry, and cry some more, and that fucking just makes everyone angry. What are all those spikes for? They're there to make you angry. I mean, cultural appropriation feels like such an odd term. The very concept of culture is to be dissected, and to diffuse. I mean, what culture doesn't just grow over time? Culture is the mixing of ideals and customs. Morals and values. Like the Circus of Values. Is that why they called it the Circus of Values? Probably. Or maybe they just didn't care. And they just named it a video game. You may already be noticing this level isn't particularly fun. Cause holy shit, we've already seen this kind of crap. The bland. Ah! Ooh! Oh, so bland. Ugh. Ugh. Oh no, it's lava. I'm gonna need a geologist over here, because I think we're dealing with a magmatic problem. Or maybe we're dealing with a squablum. Oh, it's more tech armor, ain't that spiffy? Well, that's all of those. I hope you enjoyed them, because that was all. Well, you guys are not that tough, are ya? You guys are big ol' wieners. I don't care about exploring this place, because this place fucking boring. Because I know where the secret's at. So why the fuck bother with anything else? Not to mention, I think this is where the actual treetop village begins. And so we enter the mystical land of the monkey people. Don't be afraid. The monkey people are not the same as the monkey people you know. These guys wear suits. Ho ho ho. If you thought that was racist, you might be dealing with a problem known as lightning rodism. People suffering from lightning rodism immediately assume that anything related to anything is offending someone somewhere in some way, even though they probably don't have their filters on and they're just wambling on. I mean, for fuck's sake, squabbling isn't that offensive. Only when you're in China. Chow. Yeah, one of the things that mod does is actually makes those little sparkly sparkles a little bit clearer to see. Man, this thing is pretty accurate long distance. So far, I've shot at some dudes into this twice. It's hit them pretty consistently. Like, goddamn! The Doom minigun can take a lesson from this pupper. Oh, man. I hate saying pupper. Because I love saying pupper. Pupper! He's not a pupper. He's a joik. I'm gonna teach him a lesson. Oh look, it's the ancient alien one. You see why I hate this thing? Look at that! It still hasn't killed him! How the fuck am I supposed to play a video game if I can't kill the video game? The answer is science. It's a shit AoE weapon that consumes way too much ammo. I know it's common ammo, but fuck if it isn't expensive to use. Oh no, it's an ambush. Look at that. Two grenades solves your problems. Whoops. That's who blew up. It ain't me. Enough of that. We need to focus on the task at hand. Refocus our chakras, recalibrate our gizmos, and eat our bananas raw. Rawr. That was rude, sir. I think you're supposed to jump over it. Last time, it caught me off guard, so I wasn't prepared to make a squabblum. There's nothing in any of these houses that's worth looking for. These houses are just kind of here. You can check them all if you'd like, but I sure as fuck ain't gonna give it the time of day. See, that's the problem. If he had just said squabblum, maybe there wouldn't be a squabblum. Why are they throwing baby goons at me? They all died the same way, too. Aren't you guys just a huge disappointment? Reminds me of that time in 1945, back when I was shooting bonobo monkeys in a fracas. Damn bonobo monkeys! Why won't you leave me alone? I just want to shoot you. It is my God-given right to kill species inferior to my own, such as these advanced alien prototypes. Look at their inferior design, their limp bodies, so heavy with advanced nanofiber muscle they can't even kill me. What is even the point? Well, hello. Kind of came out of nowhere. Mr. Video Game. Oh no. Those guys are really weak when you just plump them with a grenade, ain't they? Also, Turok Plus adds a grenades as regular weapons. Ain't that just a hoot and a nanny? Oh, you both ain't shit. At least you'll share that in the afterlife. And I'll be here to gloat! Wah, 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 wah. Gloat, 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 gloat. Gloat, 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 gloat. I completely forgot. I made it collect energy. Kisses. Whoops. I lost, and I stopped putting my eye on the prize, and when you stop putting your eye on the prize runs away and sleeps with your wife. That's how prizes work, isn't it? Where the heckles do I go? Oh, there's a nice purple door. It's like they knew! It's like they almost knew. Preempting the player is an important part of the video game experience. If you can't preempt the player, I don't know what the player's gonna need at any given moment. You can't make a video game without knowing what the player's gonna do. It's just common sense. It's also common sense to feed your placenta to the first gypsy you find. But for some reason, that custom hasn't been picked up in years. Ooh, he's getting peppered. Peppered with my pepper cannon. If Splatoon 2 does not feature a pepper gun, I'll be upset. Here I am, promoting their game by talking about the guy who made the videos about their game. Where is my credit? Nowhere to be found! Not even underneath the floorboards! Which is where I keep all my secrets. Why do I keep hearing a little bloop 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 bloop, like a little research bottle in a video game? Yeah, that one. Bloop, bloop. I think the way it calculates falling deaths is just how long you are above a bottomless pit or something. Maybe it's the sound of droplets of blood. Also, I'm gonna download the one where they turn the enemies into their German versions. Because the German version got, like, censored to shit, because they are like, no! After killing all those Jews, we can't kill human sepians anymore. And they made them robots! It's hilarious. I bet you those robots bleed cyber blood. Or cyber goo, because calling it blood would only inspire the next generation of Nazis. The next generation of Nazis is raised on red hot blood. Weren't that just a ripe old pickle? I want to say, but at the same time, I kind of want this level to just go on and live its own life. So let's move on. I won't regret this mistake instantly anyway. Oh, look, it's the exit portal.
Who knew?
I sure as fuck didn't. You might notice there's like a little ledge over there. Oh, look, it's a chronoceptor part. I wonder if that's a secret we're going to have to collect. The answer is yes and yes. A lot of respawning enemies, have we? Probably because we're not in the same area forever. We've been very locational flexible. Yeah, I hate those fuckers. They suck. They're just so sturdy. Their big, manly arms. I wouldn't mind falling asleep. Though, enemies take more or less damage based on the kind of weapon you hit them with. I can't help but wonder about the exact numerics behind that kind of mechanic. Those lowest fuckers are gonna have their own guns too, so that's the part that sucks the most. I think it's very telling that I'm very tired if I'm talking garbage like this. It's a clue! So hard and he came so far, but in the end it just didn't matter. It just couldn't matter. That's just sad.
I'm sad, baby.
Whatever's behind this ancient door, it's a whole bunch of beans to me. Tried his best, but he just couldn't do it. I say we applaud him serendipitously. Whatever that means. So what exactly is their strategy? Because I'm not too sure what their battle tactics are. It seems to mostly be run at Turok, which, while a fine strategy any day of the week, isn't working out too well so far. I'm having my second thoughts about these guys and their combat capabilities. I got minigun ammo, that's awesome. That's a secret. You'll understand when we get there. I can't help it if you can't. Just the two of us. Ba-ba-dum, ba-ba-dum, ba-ba-dum. Just the two of us. I can't help it if I can. Just the two of us. This man is much too handy-capable to be a handicapped man. Ah, it's the last ancient Chinese safe spot. But I say fuck it. I would have been done with this level. I did jack shit.
And yet I made so much noise.
Hello. There's a tiny baby ledge here. Did you see it? If you're dead, you are a smart man. I can't help it if you can. Just the two of us. We're gonna get a good weapon right now. It's the quad launcher! Or just the rocket launcher. Contrary to popular belief, one rocket is four rockets. So it's a really good gun for just peppering things to death. You get a surprising amount of ammo per pickup too, so don't be afraid to use the video game! His hitbox was literally just out of whack. Because he did not get hit by what he should be hit by. Oh, I see. There's more ledges than the one that I figured out. You can jump across, huh? Oh! Border of Zugbaya, Katarina. I mean, there's no reason for me to go over here. Highly doubt there's loot worth looting out of here, but sure, why not? Let's give these guys the good old-fashioned German handkerchief. Do love me the old-fashioned German handkerchief. I want to know who made those sound clips and why he's so fucking proud of me. Put him in the game. I bet you he's just fucking glowing. He's like, I made such a good ouchy noise! Gasol's trading himself to chocolate! He just stuffs an entire bar down his face like a gross blah. Come over here, boys. Let me show you how we do this West Australian style. The West Australian style involves hot peppers and a delicious pickle mix. I forgot a key, didn't I? Yep! Or not? Who knows? I sure as fuck don't. No, Mr. Bond. I expect you to pay your mortgage on time. What a rude man. Forcing a man to pay his mortgage on time. There are no words for the incivility such a request implies. Except Schmackelflugel. I stole it from the Germans. Just to insult you. No! Oh shit, I forgot. The portal isn't... It's like way too far away. Damn it. It also puts you the other way around, so you're like all confused now. I'm a sad baby as a result. I think I might have missed the key because I got too arrogant about what was wrong. On the plus side, I don't think these type of enemies respawn. So I guess they're stop. Oh, there it is. Ancient Chinese key. Imported from China. God damn it, why are there so many enemies out here? Hates. I prefer these countries back when they were filled with nothing but candy corn. Back in my day, we respected candy corn for what it was worth. 250 a pop. God damn it. I lost all my teeth to that last candy corn. But it sure was worth the economical stance it gave me. That man ate a candy corn. He must be rich. Give him a rich man job. But sir, he is stylish. I know that we don't want any of them stylish people on our team. But we can't deny a man with such grace the honor he deserves. Fight for his country and his countrymen. When your game is so boring that I just go on a tangent and shoot this guy in the back. think this game has backstab mechanics too. Or maybe Turok plus. Seems to have a very tiny hitbox. Well, I think I should be glad I don't have any fancy viewers, or I'd be in trouble for some of the comments I've made. As you may have noticed, every single one of the keys was in that one level. It's very mysterious, isn't it? Very mysterious. Next time, The Lost Land, which is an interesting level. Also one of the levels I forgot one of the secrets at, but whatever. Oh look, it's the hub. Yay! Yay! Just in time for the computer screen to start dimming.